So let's remove my IP address from here and see if that goes. Okay, so it's gone. So if we've got the IP address in, we're producing the result found. Otherwise, we're not. So let's just take it all out first of all. Okay, so if the IP address has been found, we don't want to do anything. So if it hasn't been found, we want to increment the value of the database in the count.txt file. So now what we can do is create a handle to open this file. So we're opening, we're opening, well, we'll create a variable called file name. And that's going to be count.txt. So we're opening count.txt. So we're just substituting that in there. And we're opening this to read in the value. Okay. So now what we want to do is we want to grab this data. So we can say current equals f read. And we're reading from the handle. And we need a size to specify a size. So as per the last example in the non-unique hit counter, we used the file size function and we specified file name. So now what we can do is we can close it here using the fclose function, and we can echo out current just so we know what we're doing. So if the address hasn't been found, we're going to echo out 0, which is the current value in count.txt. Now what we want to do underneath this, we don't want to echo that out anymore. Now what we want to do underneath this is say current inc equals current plus 1. So we're incrementing the value. And remember, this is all while the IP address has not been found in the database or in the count.txt file. Now what we want to do is we want to open up a new handle. So we want to F open, we want to open file name, this time to write. So if you've dealt with file handling, you'll understand this. If not, go and have a look at file handling and this will clearly make sense to you. We then want to F write, and we want to write to this current handle, and we want to write the value of current inc. Then we want to close the file. So we're closing handle. And therefore, the value has been updated because we're taking this current ink, we're adding 1 to the value of current, and then we're rewriting it into the file. So write is going to overwrite everything. So let's just double check and see if this works. So at the moment, it's 0. I'm going to refresh the page, and hopefully, well, we've got a message here saying the file count.txt has been changed. Reload. We click yes, and that's been updated to 1. So let's just close that for now. I'm going to refresh again, and you can see that if we open up count.txt, it's changed to 2. Now, this is all well and good, but at the moment, it's not unique. So, what we want to do is after we've inputted, after we've written to this file, we want to open the ip.txt file, and we want to append an IP address onto the end of it. So what we want to do here is create a new handle, and this is f open, and this time we want to open, let's go up here, we can just specify that in here actually. We want to open ip.txt, and we want to open that to append onto it. And what this means is we're going to be adding onto it. We're not going to be overwriting like we do with the W. We're not going to be reading like we do with the R, but we're appending to the end of the file. Now what we can do is we can say fwrite, and we're writing to handle. And we want to write the current IP address of the user, which is IP address here. So if we come down, IP address. Then what we want to do is we want to add a line break onto the end of it by a backslash and n. You've noticed I've used double quotation marks. This n won't be processed as a new line if you use single quotation marks. So if it's not writing to a new line for any reason, it might be because you haven't used double quotation marks. And now we can f close, and we can close this handle. So we've got a lot of repetitive code here, but perhaps you could come up with a function if you want to shorten this code up. So Now we've written to the file, we're pretty much done because we've written back to the file the IP address, and now next time when we check, our IP address is already stored, so we won't be carrying out the rest of this block, if that makes sense. So we'll come to count.txt, make sure that's zero, come to IP, make sure there's nothing in there. Now, if I was to refresh, okay, we're obviously not getting any output. Now let's open up count.txt. You can see that's now at value one. Let's close that. Let's open up ip.txt, and you can see that my IP address is written in there. Now let's close this and try and refresh again. So we've refreshed again. Now normally, without the with a non-unique hit counter, this value would have incremented here. But because we've done this loop here, the IP address should have already been detected. Found will be set to true, and therefore this block here will not be run. Sorry, this block here will not be run. So we're not going to be updating this, and we're not going to be adding the IP to the file. So let's open up count.txt. This is still at value one because we've already recognized that our IP address has visited this website. If we open up ip.txt, the IP address is still there. Nothing's been added because this has been detected. Therefore, our value has not been updated. So this is a really simple way to create a unique hit counter. The code has been reused in to some extent here, so you could perhaps come up with a function that would allow you to combine these and write particular data to them. But for now, I'm not going to be doing that because this video is just about creating the hit counter. It's totally up to you to tidy up the code from what you've learned with dealing with functions and arguments. But for now, this is the short and sharp unique hit counter.